What's up, guys? I'm Charlie. Kirby's on camera. Patrick's over there. And today we're in a rainforest in the state of Washington.
What?
Believe it.
All right, so today we're hanging out in Hoh Rain Forest in Olympic National Park. Now, there aren't any monkeys or toucans hanging out here, but it's still pretty legit. So yeah, a rainforest in the United States. It totally happens.
So there are two different kinds of rainforests in the world. There are tropical rainforests with their bananas and their colorful butterflies and their giraffes.
There aren't any giraffes in rainforests.
There are. What?
And there's also tropical rainforests, lesser known, underappreciated, but just as enchanting second cousin, temperate rainforests. Oh, pretty cool, Charlie. But what's a temperate rainforest? Ah, excellent question, Charlie. Well, to figure that out, let's toss it over to our buddy Paul Alaback, Professor Emeritus of Forest Ecology at the University of Montana and father of the North American accepted definition of temperate rainforests.
Temperate rainforests. Over 1,400 millimeters annual precipitation, cool summers stemming from an equable year-round climate, mean annual temperature between 4 and 12 degrees Celsius, and infrequent fire, except in the Redwood Fog Belt.
So basically what Professor Paul is saying is that if you have a forest, a ton of rain, and a cool summer year after year, then you might just have yourself a nice little temperate rainforest.
And that's exactly what we have here in Olympic National Park. A forest, rain, cool temps, and consistency. Because it's all about consistency.
And as far as rainforests go, this one's definitely top dog. Because there's more biomass here in Hoh Rain Forest in Olympic National Park than there is anywhere else. Biomass is a term that scientists use to help them quantify how much living stuff is in an area, and there are a whole different bunch of ways that you can calculate it. You can do it by just adding up the living things in an area, the living things plus the dead stuff that used to be alive. You can look at one species or all organically bound carbon, but usually you just add up all the plants, animals, and tiny microorganisms in an area. We've traveled to all different kinds of forests. Underwater forests, out of water forests, forests that didn't really have too much going on, and forests that were bumping with all sorts of nature stuff.
But as far as anyone knows, there's no other forest or place in the entire world that has more living stuff per acre than this place right here. Hoh Rain Forest.
It's pretty nuts because there's really so much to see here. Massive fir and spruce trees jut up through the carpet of wildflowers and ferns that cover the forest floor. Everything on the ground is surrounded by oxalis and salmonberry, making this place look like a gosh darn storybook. Fallen logs, called nurse logs, are lying all over the place, supporting the next generation of understory dwellers. And almost everything you see is covered in a thick, fluffy layer of the stuff called club moss. Imagine the most magical, enchanted fairy woodland possible. Well, we found it, because it's right here, in the state of Washington. Who would have thought? There's at least three times as much biomass here in Hoh Rain Forest than in any tropical rainforest anywhere. That's crazy. That's like jamming three tropical rainforests into one. A triple tropical rainforest. Whoa. So we obviously had to get a better look. So we grabbed our gear early one morning and set out to find the most magical tree in the whole forest.
Hey, Charles.
Morning.
What are you doing today?
It's a beautiful day in Hoh Rain Forest. We're gonna go climb a tree in the rainforest. Patrick's over here, getting his glide cam ready. We're set to go.
This is the one.
How you doing?
Doing so good.
Doing so good?
Yeah.
Did you enjoy your climb?